April 6th, stage one of Tour of the Basque Country. We came around the final corner with about a K to go. The field sprint is going, you know, guys are swerving left and right, and we're going about 60K an hour. And there were some metal poles in the middle of the road that had not been barricaded off, or there was no referee with a flag or a hay bale or anything. A few guys saw it last minute, swerved out of the way, and that just opened up right in front of me. So I had no time to react. I hit the metal poles going, yeah, about 40 miles an hour, 60K an hour, direct impact on my knee and my leg.
In April 2015, Peter Stetina was involved in what some believed at the time to be a career-ending crash. In a season where he was producing some of his best numbers, the Colorado native suffered a monumental setback.
Shattered my kneecap, cracked my tibia from the top down, tibial plateau, tore my LCL and five ribs. You didn't feel anything at first. It was, you know, you're so programmed to like get up and just get across the line. You knew that if you just get across the line, you have pack time. And before the, I think I hit so hard, I actually killed a lot of nerves immediately. And I remember trying to get up with all the adrenaline, and I kind of realized I couldn't and my leg wouldn't move. And then pretty soon after that, the team director was holding me down saying like, no, no, don't worry about it. You're not gonna finish this one. And then they packed me up pretty quick. And then that's when I realized that it was pretty bad. And then the pain really started to set in. The majority of people believed it was the end of my career. And I did a lot of back and forths. I mean, there's quite a few dark days after that.
The light that shone through those dark moments was his passion for racing.
It is the first circles, 90 millimeter cranks, but it's a start.
And then you also realize that this isn't something you want to give up yet, and it is something that you need to see out and finish out. And I told myself that I still need a functioning leg for the rest of my life, even if I don't race a bike, because I want to be able to, you know, play soccer with my kids someday or whatever. And so I at least needed to use the tools I have as an elite athlete to rehab the best I can for the rest of my life. So that kind of became my excuse, and that became my training.
And just 4 months after his crash, Stetina was back at the Tour of Utah.
The metal was all out of the knee, but it was still a little weak in case of a crash. You had to be careful. So all the metal was still in my leg, rod and 14 screws, but it healed well. And so I had been riding my bike for about 3 weeks, actually training for about 3 weeks.
Stetina's comeback momentum continued pretty quickly, with another World Tour contract soon on the table.
Trek got pretty concrete real quickly after they saw me start Tour Utah. They said, you know, we believe you can come back if you're already racing and able to hang in the peloton.
Formerly known as a big team player, the crash has since helped focus Stetina's sights on individual as well as more unselfish success.
You know, one thing you realize when you have an event like this happen is, at the end of the day, it's still your career and your livelihood, and you can't always just ride in the service of others in anonymity. You need your own chances for your own life, and Trek really provided that. You know, they wanted to have a bit more of an American flair, and the American races are important for their markets. And at the same time, they also need help in those grand tours, and especially the mountains. They're looking to really bolster that up. So I fit in what Luca and Trek were looking for. In terms of how I judge my season is, you know, it's one, get back to 100%. Overall health is way more important. Two, race California for myself and for Trek and try to bring home something big. Three, try to make the tour team and help Boak in the mountains. And then four, as an American, you always want to go to the Olympics. And it's a climber's course this year, so that's you know, the holy grail as well.